Let's start up with chapter number 9 from First Flight in English Literature. Madam Rides the Bus by Wally Kannan. Okay, children, I would like to ask one small question from you all. That how many of you love to ride by bus or love to travel? Or another question, how many of you love traveling? Traveling by bus, isn't it a strange idea? Because in such a passionate time and such a fast forward time, bus becomes a little less opted idea, isn't it, children? So what about this little girl or boy who loves to ride by the bus? And he or she, whosoever is the central character of this story, wants to travel by a bus. A little wicked idea, isn't it? So let's discover what is the plot of this chapter. Let's see, is it really a travelogue or what else is it? So children, let's start up chapter number 9, Madam Rides the Bus. This is a small introduction of this little chapter or a story, Madam Rides the Bus. The lesson, Madam Rides the Bus, is about a brave 8-year-old girl who had a strong desire and along with it, courage to fulfill it. Now, what is the desire and courage invoked? She liked gazing at the hustle bustle of the street, and her favorite part was the sight of a bus arriving and departing. Thus, she developed a deep desire to travel by bus. For that, she needed all sorts of information about this bus journey, collect the bus fare, and then plan it so that she could be back at home before her mother woke up from her afternoon nap. Thus, the story brings us and recounts of how innocently but responsibly this girl fulfilled her deepest desire and discloses her experience on the bus ride. Now, in the end also, it invokes the power of courage and desire altogether, but inflicts that how a little incident makes her realize the reality of death. Apart from her desire, another concept of how life is important is also enclosed. So let's see what happens in this very interesting story. Before starting with the story, let's have a look on new words and their meanings. First word, wistfully, that is longingly. Kindle, satellite hair or feelings. A slang expression, informal words often used with a close group. Discreet questions, careful questions. Slack time, rhyme when there is not much work. Curtly, showing displeasure. Drivel, silly nonsense. Haughtily, proudly. Mimicking, copying. Repulsive, causing strong dislike. So, after going through the difficult words and their meanings, let's switch up to the NCERT textbook of First Flight. We'll come across many more difficult words also. For this part, these are the words. These are the set of difficult words. So let's start up with the reading portion and then explanation from the NCERT textbook. There was a girl named Valayamma, who was called Wally for short. She was 8 years old and very curious about things. Her favorite pastime was standing in the front doorway of her house, watching what was happening in the street outside. There were no playmates of her own age on her street, and this was about all she had to do. Curious, eager to know or learn something. The story is about an 8-year-old girl named Wali Amai, or preferably Wali. Just like every child, Wali is eager to know about new and unknown things, because of which she can spend all day looking at the hustle bustle of the street. Moreover, she has no friends to play with, so the only option she has is to look at what is going on outside. Fascinating thing of all was the bus that traveled between her village and the nearest town. It passed through her street each hour, once going to the town and once coming back. The side of the bus filled each time with a new set of passengers was a source of unending joy for Wali. Day after day, she watched the bus, and gradually a tiny wish crept into her head and grew there. She wanted to ride on that bus, even if just once. This wish became stronger and stronger until it was an overwhelming desire. Wali would stare wistfully at the people who got on or off the bus when it stopped at the street corner. Their faces would kindle in her longings, dreams, and hopes. If one of her friends happened to ride the bus and tried to describe the sights of the town to her, Wali would be too jealous to listen and would shout in English, "Proud, proud." Neither she nor her friends really understood the meaning of the word, but they used it often as a slang expression of disapproval. Over many days and months, Wali listened carefully to conversations between her neighbors and people who regularly used the bus, and she also asked a few discreet questions here and there. This way, she picked up various small details about the bus journey. The town was 6 miles from her village. The fare was 30 paise one way, which is almost nothing at all. She heard one well-dressed man say, "But to Wali, who scarcely saw that much money from 1 month to the next, it seemed a fortune." The trip of the town took 45 minutes. On reaching town, if she stayed in her seat and paid another 30 paise, she could return home on the same bus. This meant that she could take the 1 o'clock afternoon bus, reach the town at 1:45, and be back home by about 2:45. On and on went her thoughts as she calculated and recalculated, planned, replanned, that how she can actually ride a bus. Well, one fine spring day, the afternoon bus was just on the point of leaving the village and turning to the main highway when a small village voice and turning into the main highway when a small voice was heard shouting, "Stop the bus, stop the bus," and a tiny hand was raised commandingly. The bus slowed down to a crawl, and the conductor, sticking his head out the door, said, "Hurry then, tell whoever it is to come quickly." "It's me," shouted Wali. "I'm the one who has to get on." By now, the bus had come to a stop, and the conductor said, "Oh really? You don't say so." "Yes, I simply have to go to town," said Wali, still standing outside the bus. "And here's my money." She showed him some coins. Okay, but first you must get on the bus," said the conductor. And he stretched out a hand to help her. "Never mind," she said. "I can get on by myself." You don't have to help me. The conductor was a jolly sort, fond of joking. Oh, please, don't be angry with me, my fine madam, he said. Here, have a seat right up there in front. Everybody move aside, please. Make way for madam. It was the slack time of day, and there were only 6 or 7 passengers on the bus. They were all looking at Wally and laughing with conductor. Wally was overcome with shyness, avoiding everyone's eyes. She walked quickly to an empty seat and sat down. May we stand now, madam? The conductor asked, smiling. Then he blew his whistle twice and the bus moved forward with a roar. It was a new bus. Its outside painted a gleaming white with some green stripes along with sides. Inside, the overhead bars shone like silver. Directly in front of Wally, above the windshield, there was a beautiful clock. The seats were soft and luxurious. Wally devoured everything with her eyes. But when she started to look outside, she found her view cut off by a canvas blind that covered the lower part of her window. So she stood up on the seat and peered over the blind. The bus was now going along the bank of a canal. The road was very narrow. On one side there was the canal, and beyond it, palm trees, grassland, distant mountains, and the blue sky. On the other side was a deep ditch, and then acres and acres of green fields. Green, as far as I could see, it was just green. Oh, it was all so wonderful. Suddenly, she was startled by a voice. Listen, child, said the voice. You should not stand like this. Stand, please. Sitting down, she looked to see who had spoken. It was an elderly man who had honestly been concerned for her. But she was annoyed by his attention. There's nobody here who's a child, she said haughtily. I've paid my 30 paise like everyone else. The conductor chimed in. Oh, sir, but this is a very grown-up madam. Do you think a mere girl could pay her own fare and travel to the city all alone? Wally shot an angry glance at the conductor and said, I am not a madam. Please remember that. And you have not yet given my ticket. I'll remember, the conductor said, mimicking her tone. Everyone laughed, and gradually Wally too joined in the laughter. The conductor punched the ticket and handed it to her. Just sit back and make yourself comfortable. Why should you stand when you have paid for a seat? Because I want to, she answered, standing up again. But if you stand on the seat, you may fall and hurt yourself. When the bus makes a sharp turn or hits a bump, that's why we want you to sit down, child. I am not child, I tell you, she said irritably. I'm 8 years old. Of course, how stupid of me, 8 years my. The bus stopped, some new passengers got on, and the conductor got busy for a time. Afraid of losing her seat, Wally finally sat down. An elderly woman came and sat beside her. Are you all alone, dear? She asked Wally as the bus started again. Wally found the woman absolutely repulsive. Such big holes she had in her earlobes and such ugly earrings in them. And she could smell the betel nut the woman was chewing and see the betel juice that was threatening to spill over her lips at any moment. Ugh. Who could be so sociable with such a person? Yes, I'm traveling alone, she answered curtly. And I have got a ticket too. Yes, she's on her way to town, said the conductor with a 30 paisa ticket. Oh, why don't you mind your own business, said Wali. But she laughed all the same, and the conductor laughed too. But the old woman went on with her drivel. Is it proper for such a young person to travel alone? Do you know exactly where you are going in town? What's the street? What's the house number? You need not bother about me. I can take care of myself, Wali said, turning her face towards the window and staring out. So children, putting up a pause on the reading section, let's have an explanation. Children, when we are talking about this little girl named as Wali, so what we can sum up is that she's very keen, she is very enthusiastic, she is full of excitement, she has the courage to travel alone, and finally, as she wanted to, as she planned that she'll travel by bus, and she wants to travel and gaze the beautiful outskirts of the land of her village. So finally she's able to travel, sit in a bus, travel and take a ride. But on the way, in the starting of the journey, the conductor pleases her and addresses her with the particular notification of madam or 8-year child. At that time, she doesn't likes the conductor or anyone to call her or address her with this particular addressal of little child. She wants that everyone should respect her as a passenger. She should not be taken like a small kid of 8 years, as she has paid for the ticket, especially the 30 paisa. So she feels that she is equivalent to each and every passenger traveling in the bus. Fine, right now the journey has started and she is enjoying this journey of hers. Wali, if we say about the nature and behavior of Wali after reading the set of lines, we can judge that Wali actually doesn't feel bad about anything. She is a fun-loving creature, as well as she is a person who actually cares for self-respect, and she doesn't want extra attention. She has a proper taste that when she has a level, she has a standard of talking to the people, she doesn't get too friendly with anyone immediately. When talking about the lady who meets up, tries to entertain Wali, at that time Wali does not actually find that lady enterprising and much sociable. So she keeps the conversation at bay. So for now, children, that's it. And we'll continue this chapter in the next class. Thank you and sayonara. Have a great day ahead.